These are king penguins.
They sound like kazoos.
And we're taking selfies on the beach with the locals.
Perfect.
I'm Alizé Carrère, an environmental anthropologist and National Geographic explorer. This is my friend Tom Ritchie, a naturalist who spent decades in the field. Together, we'll discover what it means to be a modern explorer. Today, we're going on an expedition to South Georgia, an island within the Antarctic climate. This remote island is a sight to behold. Ice is abundant here, both in the surrounding waters and on land. Glaciers dot the landscape, and untraversable peaks make this island inhospitable, at least for humans. We're starting the day off early. Tom and I are headed for this rocky shore. But those little specks aren't rocks. They're penguins, king penguins to be exact.
The whole purpose is to come here very early in the morning, get ashore before sunrise, so it's, what is it, 5:45 right now. And that's a good time to be here.
Before they wake up and head out to hunt at sea.
I love the sound a penguin makes. They're like, they sound like kazoos. They kind of roll up, and then you see their chest get big, and then they go.
But you watch them, they're heaving, you know, their chest heaves when they make the call.
It's so cute.
It's always good to try for early morning landings like this because, you know, you might get that early morning sunlight. Everything's just starting to get active. Many of them are going out to sea. They're going to go off to feed. And they can sometimes be off for several days, depending on how far they go.
But getting to the ocean isn't always easy. Penguins aren't exactly known for being agile on land. But when you throw a little mud into the mix, it's a complete disaster. It's enough to make you wonder how in the world they can survive in the open ocean. Well, once they finish making a mess of themselves and actually get to the shore, it's clear the water is their real home. They regularly swim hundreds of miles in search of fish, and they've been tracked diving down 1,000 feet in search of prey. They are relentless. If you were a fish, getting this close would be a pretty scary sight. Famously, penguins can't fly. In fact, their ancestors on the coast of New Zealand were already grounded more than 60 million years ago. And over generations, their wings evolved to push through water instead of air. An adaptation perfect for a life at sea. Maybe it's time to reconsider the penguin. Instead of a clumsy ice butler, let's think of them as the deep divers of the sea. Our tools are different, our technology is different, and the landscape is changing. Exploring means something very different from the past. But there will always be room to observe and protect the wonder of our world. And that's what makes a modern explorer.